What is it, David? You know, David, I asked you to... How did you get in here?
Well, do you think you're the only one who can charm a virile young stud like your secretary?
Catherine, I am very busy. I've already wasted enough time today.
Don't worry, I have no intention of wasting any time.
What do you want?
I wanted to share a drink with you.
A drink? Are you out of your mind?
Champagne, girl. Finest vintage of the century.
That bottle's been opened.
Oh, yes, I couldn't wait to get started. There's plenty more in here.
You're drinking again?
Indeed, I am.
You said it was a celebration.
You know that Philip and I were married 25 years ago today. We live in our silver anniversary.
Do you really think that marriage would have made it to the 25th year?
It would have made it from here and beyond, if not for you, Joe.
You are fantasizing again. You know, whatever little corner of heaven Philip is in right now, I'm sure the cosmic joke up there is you and your delusions of romance. That marriage was hitting the skids before I ever even met Philip.
It is not true.
What he told me.
You are lying.
No, I'm not. So there. Look what you've gone and done. You've got yourself all messy drunk again. And for what? A pipe dream. You were nothing to Philip. I was everything. Let me call you a cab. Which tank would you like to dry out in this time?
That isn't the only reason I'm celebrating.
Oh, really? Whatever other wonderful occasion is there?
Your death. Put down the phone.
Don't you point that thing at me.
What's the matter? Are you afraid it might come out?
Catherine, don't be foolish. I said put it down!
I suggest you start making your peace, my tramping little friend. Your years on this earth are waning.
Damn, but that isn't funny, Catherine.
Yeah, it may not be funny to you, but it's a delight to me. How does it feel to know that you're going to be judged for everything you've done in your life?
No, Catherine, please. Please don't.
Bye, Fran.
Now I see the real me.